App Coder. Hope you are doing well. I am Satendra. Today I am going to show you how to load data on table view in our iOS application. Let's get into it. Search for Xcode, open it, click on create a new project, select single view application, proceed with next button. In product name section, we need to give our name of our project. So in our case, it will be demo table data. Proceed with next button. Click on create button. Now our project is created. We need to open main storyboard. This is our view controller. Click on this plus icon. Now we need to search table view. Drag table view on our view controller. Now we need to set constraint for our table view. In our case, it will be 0, 0, 0 and 0. Now our table view is set on our view controller. Now we need to create property outlet for our table view. So press Ctrl and drag on our view controller. We need to give outlet name. It will be table data. Hit enter. Table data is property or outlet of our table view. Now we need to connect data source of our table view. Select table view and press hold and drag cursor on view controller. Now we need to attach data source. Data source is responsible for providing the data for our table view. Now we need to add prototype cell. You can add it by clicking here. Prototype cell is just a template for your cell appearance. Every cell needs an identifier. So we need to give cell identifier over here. In our case, it will be cell. Let's start coding. Open our view controller class. Add extension for our view controller class. Implement protocol of table view data source. We have some method for data source, means displaying the data on table view. First method is number of rows in section. The return type of this method is integer, so we need to return value is in integer. In our case, we will return 3. It means we are creating 3 rows in our table view. And another method is table view cell for row at index path. Let's creating the variable for it. Let cell table view dot dq reusable cell with identifier. By using dq reusable cell means we are about to use template cell over and over. The return type of this method is UI table view cell. So we'll return cell. Okay. In identifier, as we know, we have give identifier to our template cell, prototype template cell. You can copy here and paste it over here. Index path. Now we need something to show on table view. So cell dot label, text label. This is the default property for our prototype cell dot text. So I am assigning is I am Sachin. Now you can run it by command R on simulator. As you can see, by this method, number of rows in section returning 3, we have 3 cells in our table view, and this is for displaying the data. I am Sachin over here on all our 3 cells. To use array for returning the values in table view, let create array for names. John, Arthur, Vic, Lee. This is our array. You can return array count over here, names.count. array.count, and you can return array values like for first cell John, Atif, Vic and Lee. Array name and index path dot row. Run it again. As you can see, we have our array in our table view set. So that is it for today, guys. Do subscribe the channel, like the video if it is helpful, leave comment if you have any questions. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.